time for more progress. Actually, you're not. You aren't. I'm probably just gonna. Yeah. Them. So. You. Excuse you. I do plan on testing it when we get to the point where it might matter, but I don't think it'll work out being able to rely on just three clerics to do the job efficiently enough. Another level or two isn't gonna likely to make a big enough difference. And when Wizard aren't changed, they will be first level fighter types. Will quickly level a few times, but won't be particularly good at the job either. Simply because they'll be level one, because their stats and gear matter less than that. Stats and gear don't matter. But the class levels, well, the class and levels in said class matter more. In ways that we're not allowed to see. So. Whatever advancement they can. Until this one is ready to make 13th level, I think. Because at that point, Wiz and Ard should be done with Mage and have converted and made a little bit of progress in whatever fancy classes they end up in. Like I said last time, I suspect I'll make one a lord and the other a samurai. Party could be full of fucking mages, because that's where the current lord will end up, where the two not ready to be thieves yet will end up, where all three of these clerics are going after they're done being clerics. So, yeah. Figure the way I'm gonna do it is once was an ardor converted, well, let these clerics finish being clerics. Get to 13, because I suspect that's where that's gonna sit, is that'll happen. They'll get to level 13 mage, get their spells before she gets to level 13. Have her swap. Maybe not take her out then. Because she'll still need to grind through mage. But it'll be easier to work with a party of five. Because it's divided across fewer people. And there's no rounding. The losing XP in rounding bothers me. Because the three clerics we've got now are behind in how much of how many classes they've got, giving them some slightly more focused time. They hit 13 and swap over to mage, then add that current lord who will have already been swapped over to mage and taken out back in so that they can all work on mage again. And then some point. Either at or before they get to 13 and get all their spells. CMXs to get through all their spells, having made level 13 as a mage, have all their spells, and sit there and wait while I'm leveling up other people. And then, once I've got them all there, figure out who's going to be what. Other than Wiz and Ard, who need to convert to fighting types so that I have them, because they're the ones that'll be ready first. So, that decision has been made for them by virtue of I did not think about how I'd actually want my party when I first started. Since they'll all have their stats by the time they've gone through cleric and mage, really, I guess it'll just be a matter of who's got more hit points. Same with the mage thieves. Once they get through mage, since that's the only thing they're gonna do, I can convert them both to thief. But the one that's already been converted has made some levels, so I'll probably just use her. CMXs. Since I'm gonna have should lead them at level 13 mage, and then if and when I end up needing the spare, then change them to the class I need. That's what makes sense. I've been keeping count of how much damage Murphy would have had if it were only damage delivered by the clerics. In the previous fight, the round where Vor, of course, killed him, he would have only had 4 points of damage accumulated. This fight so far, none. Oh, now it's 7. 6. Even if they can get the job done, if they don't get profoundly lucky over and over and over again, it's going to be a slog. spells. And now you both have the 4 you were supposed to. Remembered that one of the classes didn't have numbers that lined up, but I wanted the total number of experience they need for the level after, which I can't see. Until they make the next one, which, no. If it's correct, the one after that will require 629, 663. Which is a lot. They're not even halfway. They're a level and a half away, and they're not even halfway there in total number of XP, because it's just that much more expensive, right? This won't be perfect, because however many Murphys we end up with, that's a bunch of levels. That's a bunch of levels worth after they make 13. Before she will. 9 to 10 levels worth. Of XP. And the gap between these two going up to 13 and her getting there. So, yeah, that would be a lot of progress. I don't want her to do that, though. I don't want her to do that. Because of how long that would take. So. I may suck it up and just deal with the unusable overflow. Because I don't want to spend that long in a class that's not being, once it's no longer necessary or productive. So she'll end up at 12 and a half levels, give or take, which is an ugly place to be. I don't like that. I wonder if you would be useful enough. Such that when she hits 12, swap her to mage, take her out, and put you in the front row? Until they finish with their levels? In mage, or finish their level in mage. Maybe. You should be slightly better at secondary combatant than clerics, but I don't know. Either way, we won't be there next time, so I don't have to worry about it yet. I could test that in a different way. I could test that in a different way. Either way, not now. They got the spells they were behind, and getting them up to 10 next time wouldn't take too long. Like, this should be a grinding stream instead of an episode long. And then mental math for the shuffling of classes shit show can Wait. It will still need to happen, but it... Not quite